welcome to March. February is finally over, which is awesome. I always say it has the shortest amount of days because it sucks the most. Did you know more people kill themselves in the month of February than any other month, which is why, thank goodness, it's the shortest month, but then also why I felt it was super important in March to have this reading center around our happiness, okay? So there are a lot of reasons why people watch these videos, but at the very core of it, I think that people are watching because they want some good news, right? They want something to look forward to. In the words of Omar Suleiman, a very wise guy, he says that the keys to happiness are three things: something to love, something to do, and something to look forward to. So hopefully I'm going to give you all of those in this reading. So even if your life is already full of joy and happiness and bliss, if you're just wanting to hear some validation about these good vibes that you're already feeling, that, you know, to hear you're already on the right path, that you're making the right choices, the right decisions, for that sense of security, security does bring happiness, right? Knowing what to expect. At the end of the day, happiness is what we're all seeking. It's the reason why we seek out help, why we would use tarot reader, why we would look up our horoscope. This is why we're doing this, okay? We are fiends for happiness. It's the ultimate drug. And so this is what we're focusing on in March. So this will be for your sun, moon, or rising sign. A lot of times, because our moon sign correlates to our emotions and how we feel, which is a lot of times why we make the decisions we make, that might resonate a little bit better for you. So it might be advisable to watch your moon sign as well as your sun sign. And then you could do your rising sign as well too, if you'd like to. What did I want to say? Okay, so since we're focusing on happiness for March and how to kind of sustain that throughout the year, this is how we're going to look at it. We're going to do where are you at right now? What is tainting any feelings of happiness that you otherwise should have right now? What will make you feel happy, or at least what you think will? How is that perception true? How is that perception false? What will actually make you the most happy this month? And then we're going to look at the forces that are kind of outside of your control, right, that is affecting this state, and which ones that are not really within your power are kind of accelerating your happiness, and then which ones are decelerating that. We're going to look at what's going to bring you luck this month, your crystal of the month, your color energy, your lucky days, and then also any energies that you need to kind of bring into your life in order to help the happiness thrive, how to sustain the happiness once you get some, and then just kind of like a recap or overall nutshell of what March will look like for your sign. So, kind of thinking about, you know, okay, well, is this reading going to be enough because it's for each specific zodiac sign? Each sign has their own. Then I was thinking, those of you who have followed me for a long time might remember stop, drop, roll readings, where it's something that you stop doing, something you drop from your life, and something you should roll with. I think I'm going to do a special on those, but really kind of amped up or accelerated in order to really harness in on that happiness sort of life coaching aspect. And the reason why I think this is important in March is because, number one, it's the perfect time for spring cleaning, right? Number two, the popularity of Marie Kondo right now, and, you know, sort of thinking about, let's get rid of the things that don't bring me joy. Let's just focus on the things that bring me joy. And, you know, we all are always looking for joy. We're either trying to increase pleasure or decrease pain. And so that's kind of the purpose of this reading. And then here's the other thing. We're about to step into this Mercury retrograde. We're in the pre-shadow period right now as I record this. And so then when it hits us, in order to use this time in its fullest potential, we want to very much evaluate, okay, this isn't working for me. I want to pitch this and I want to do something that's going to make my life better. It's going to make me happier. It's going to make me more joyful, more satisfied with life. And so I think I'm going to offer that like in sort of a goals and coaching, very intensive sort of way as a special. Once I decide to do that, if you're on the email list, I only send one email a month, so don't let that be a reason why you're not on my list. Then you'll be notified of that. And if there's like a coupon code or something, that would be in there. If you're not on the list, you should be, because I give away, like I said, it's only one email a month, but every single month I give away a free 20-minute video reading to a random person selected from my list. So that being said, I'm sorry if this long intro did not bring you joy, if it decreased your happiness, but now you know what to expect in your reading. So let's get started. Hey Taurus, welcome to March. Okay, so what's going on for you right now? And they're saying things haven't changed, you know, and you really don't have much feeling or judgment about that, which is good that you're being somewhat neutral. They're saying there's a lot to look forward to be honest, that you've been thinking a lot more than usual about your emotions and how those kind of play out in your day-to-day life and thinking about what's important to you and what you really want. And so that's fantastic news, because until we really know what it is that we want, it's hard to sort of get what we want, right? So anyway, the thing is here that there are some things that are sort of tainting your feelings of happiness or joy. And they say the biggest challenge with that is like kind of knowing, is this worth investing in or not? Is this relationship something I want to continue or not? Is this job opportunity something I really want to take on because it's more hours? You know, is this home improvement sort of thing that I'm thinking, you know what, this is going to make me feel really happy if I change the colors in my living room. But like, do I really want to go through all the work of like buying the paint and painting it myself and blah, blah, blah. So you're really having a hard time making that decision. And that might be one decision that you want to make. And so it's somewhat like depressing you that you feel like you can't decide about certain things, that you're wondering, you know, is it worth the investment or not? Straight out the gate, I'll just say, hey, why don't you get a tarot reading? I'll tell you. Why don't you read for yourself or have a friend do it? You know, whoever your favorite tarot reader is. Duh. Hello. Because if you sit in this energy of, I don't really know if it's worth it, like, then you just start to feel negative about having to make the decision in the first place. And so you're carrying that negativity every day you don't decide, because indecision is a decision, with you. And then you feel like shit because you didn't make choice. So make a choice, regardless. I mean, if you make the wrong choice, then it's just an opportunity to make another one. But it's not unusual that you'd feel that way right now with the Mercury retrograde kind of energy. So I'm not like saying, hey, Taurus, you're being an idiot. No, it's totally normal. But you probably do want to make a decision and kind of assess, you know, hey, are these things worth it or not? Or are these things that I want to achieve or do at the completion of the retrograde, when maybe they're going to kind of come and go a little bit easier in my life? So anyway, they're saying you're not really connected to your spiritual self. If you're a person who prays usually and that's how you connect, you're not, you know, praying all the time, or you're not doing it in a very connected way. You're not necessarily doing it with intention. It's more of like routine and meaningless, therefore. So they're saying shift your perspective on this. Like, you won't be disappointed. No matter how you connect to your spiritual self, whether that's through yoga, whether that's through, you know, touching trees outside, getting grounded, or reading your own tarot cards, whatever your version of spirituality is, you need to connect to that kind of realm, because there's a lot of support there for you. And so I'm going to switch decks here and find out for Taurus what is the best way for you to kind of connect to that energy. And so this is really cool, because what they're saying is for most of you, it's not going to have anything to do with nature or getting grounded. For the majority of you, it's going to be through art. So I don't know if you ever notice, let's say that you are, and art comes in all forms. It could be writing, it could be painting, it could be pottery, it could even be gardening. But whenever you're in this energy of creating something, okay? Now, you know, do you ever notice you get in the flow of something, right? And then maybe I'm typing out an email and I'm in the flow of it. That's art right there, okay? And my son walks up and he says, Mom, Mom, Mom. And I said, hold on a second, let me finish this. You know, because that's divine energy flowing through you when you are in the flow. Art can even be cleaning your house. you know, make it creating a sparkly and clean, shiny environment. Now, for the rest of you, but less so, it would be in regards to the law of attraction, manifesting things that you want on purpose. But for a lot of you, that will be challenging because even though you're kind of starting to figure out what you want, you're more focused on how do I achieve it when it's not really up to you how things are achieved. I mean, yes, co-creation is a thing. You need to be in the right place at the right time. You know, you have to create a certain aspect of your circumstance in order for the universe to give you things in certain regards, you know, but that being said, it's more up to the universe, like how things happen, you know, to achieve what we want. We don't need to worry about that process. We just need to do our piece. And so when we're connected to our spirit guides, you know, to angels, God, Allah, energy, whatever it is you think, the universe, whatever your belief system is, it's all the same, to be honest. When you're connected to that, then it's easier to make those decisions about what you should invest in and, you know, to achieve all of the things that you want. And then the law of attraction kind of happens naturally for you. So that being said, coming back to what I'm supposed to be on task with, what do you think will make you happy in March? And they're saying a lot of you feel like, you know, well, maybe I'm just not meant to be happy. And so if I am not communicating with other people, if I am not reaching out and, you know, talking to my friends as much as I used to, or, you know, talking to my family as much as I used to, or if I lie and say that I'm happy, maybe I'll be happier. Or maybe at least I won't make things worse by, you know, spreading the pain around. That's fucked up. So how is this perception false? And they go, this is a weak-ass perception and you know it. This is not historically the way that you handle things. This is not normal for you. And, you know, I mean, yeah, sometimes trying a new way is good, but this is not right for you. How is your perception true? They go, well, it's a self-fulfilling prophecy. If you decide, you know, this month that you're just going to pretend like everything's fine and you're going to be bummed out and disappointed and that's just the way that life is, well, then guess what? That is going to be the way that your life is going to be. It's going to be like just a fucking subtle undercurrent of sadness forever. Because it's not like bad things are going to happen, but if you just decide that you're dissatisfied with life and that's just the way things are going to be and I'm not going to do anything to change it and I'm not going to talk about this and I'm not going to work through it and I'm definitely not going to, you know, reach out to the spirit world to help me move past this, I'm not going to deal with it. Well, guess what? Then that is your forever outcome. It really is. And they're saying, why are you pushing people away? You know, there are people who care about you, or not even people even. Like your spirit guides, they want to help you, but they have a code of ethics, okay? So you have to ask them before they can intervene, except for in certain circumstances. But this video isn't on the code of ethics that they have, okay? So what they're saying is if you decide that happily ever after doesn't exist, that true happiness doesn't exist, and you decide not to take any action steps in regards to finding that or, you know, achieving it, well then, yeah, you are going to be unhappy. 100%. You're right. That's your reality. Now, for the rest of you, because there are some Tauruses who, you know, where we started with that hope card, with the star card of like, okay, I'm figuring it out. You know, what's the difference here for you? And they say, you know, things are going to culminate into bigger and more beautiful things than you even thought possible. And they're like, there's really no action step for you to take this month. It's not about like, it's not about finding a new job. It's not about buying a new car. It's not about anything like that, any sort of earthy energies. It's just about allowing other people to show you love. And it's about, you know, accepting gifts from other people. So this is big. If you want to have, you know, a certain thing manifest into your life, or if you want to find, you know, a soulmate, or you want to have enough money where it's not stressful for you, or, you know, you want to find a way to, you know, help orphans in India, whatever your dream is, whatever it is that you hope for, it's only possible if you allow other people to help you, if you express what these needs and dreams are. And so you know, oftentimes we think we can handle everything ourselves, but we are not only disservicing ourselves by not allowing other people to help us, we are also disservicing other people. So I know I use this example a lot, but it's because it works. So you're carrying bags, right? And somebody says, let me get the door for you. And you say, no, I got it, because you don't want to be a burden to them. But holding a door for somebody really isn't a burden, number one. So now it's more of a struggle for you to get through the door with all those heavy bags if you said no and they walked on through. And now this person was deprived an opportunity to feel good about doing something good for another person today. So, you know, positive psychology studies are proving now that the quickest way to get out of a depressive state is by helping others and showing others love and care. So it not only helps people, like, you know, there's depression medicines like SSRIs, and obviously everybody is different, but it helps people come out of their depressive states 70% quicker than medications, and increases their happiness by 30% more than medication alone. So that being said, you not only did screw yourself over by not allowing somebody to help you to feel that love and compassion and care, but now the other person also was deprived an opportunity to maybe heal what was inside of them by doing something kind. So every time that somebody says, hey, you look really beautiful today, and you go, oh, this old thing, no, you say, thank you. Thank you very much for saying that. That makes me feel good. Because now you feel good and they feel good. If somebody compliments you and you are like, oh, and you're uncomfortable with it, now you're uncomfortable and they're uncomfortable. So instead, you can spread joy by receiving, okay, and just saying thank you. Hey, let me get lunch. Let me pay for that. Oh, thank you. I really appreciate that. Now this person feels special because they did that instead of arguing over the bill and now it's negative and awkward. Let's like kind of reduce the negativity and the awkwardness in receiving things and just be okay with it, you know? Hey, let me buy, I bought you this gift. Oh, that's too much. Wow, that's so generous of you. Thank you. Now you feel awesome that you got a gift and they feel awesome that they gave it to you. You see what I mean? I could go on and on, but this is very important for you, because if you want to get the things that you want, you have to be open to receive things, gifts, and miracles from the universe. Because if you can't accept those from human beings, how the fuck are you gonna get like a massive gift from the universe? I mean, the universe is a bigger deal, right? Just saying. So yeah, expect miracles and say thank you, and, you know, allow other people to help you. Even if it's just that they're gonna listen to you, you know, that they're gonna let you vent or whatever the case may be, you need to be open to receive love and kindness and compassion and care and even gifts. Okay, so what's going to make you the most happy? And that's what they're saying. You know, not only do you need to be open to receiving those things, but then also being generous with other people. So this is a very important message for Tauruses. What kind of forces are at play outside of your control that are in favor of your happiness? And they say, you know, for the most part, there is a good amount of emotional balance here. Like, you're pretty aware of the difference between reality and how you feel and like how they kind of interact with each other. And then also the kindness and generosity of other people as well as yourself, and that kind of coming back at you tenfold, is a massive way to kind of increase your happiness. Now, people are going to naturally want to give things to you. They're going to want to be kind to you. And so those are blessings, and this will increase your happiness should you use that right and not make it awkward. Also, if you're feeling in a generous mood, you know, from a karmic standpoint, whatever you give out, you're going to get back anywhere between 3 and 10 times as much. So the love that you give out, you get back times 3 to 10. This month, it seems like for you, it's a massive benefit that it comes back to you times 10. So, you know, maybe you tip the barista $1 at the coffee shop when nobody else is tipping, and then you get $10 off your next purchase at, you know, some place you were going to shop anyway. That kind of a thing. Blessings come in weird ways, but they do come back to you. And so they're saying it's going to be challenging to kind of recognize this and kind of see it in action. I'm sorry, I have a fuzzy in my mouth. There we go. But if you really pay attention, some of the times this month you're going to be able to pick up on that and notice it. And you're like, So what's kind of outside of your control but working against your happiness this month? And they say, if you shift your perception, nothing. Absolutely nothing. Because of that emotional balance. Now, if you don't shift your perception, if you say, oh, everything in this reading, total bullshit, I'm not going to listen to it. They're like, you're going to be sad, super depressed, sorry about it, and alone. You're also going to be very alone and unsupported. So you pick, okay? Now, what's going to bring you luck this month? Your lucky day this month is the 18th, which was also the lucky day of Virgo. So if you have Taurus and Virgo in your chart, very lucky day. Now, your crystal of the month, are you surprised that it relates to the heart chakra? I'm not. Because we need to open up our heart chakra in order to receive gifts from other people. Okay, so what's this about? The heart chakra stone aventurine, it really helps you to feel deeply satisfied as well as relaxed. It helps you to feel comfortable and balanced in things. It really helps kind of eliminate emotional stressors. And if you use this with rose quartz, though, it'll be very, very strong. And we might have some more emotional stressors than usual because we're forced to look at our past with the Mercury retrograde. And then, you know, we get frustrated because, like, our technology doesn't work right, that kind of stuff. It increases feelings of being loved. So, you know, if we've been pushing that away before and now we're going to be more open to it, this is going to help us to receive that. It stimulates creativity, which is important because a lot of you who are maybe feeling like a little bit dumpy this month, it's a powerful month for you to be creating things of art, you know? So you'll be more creative in the way that you carry that stuff through. It encourages, you know, tolerance and it kind of helps you to follow your own heart, you know, so towards that hope card, that star card, towards the things that we want. It gets rid of like any sort of suffering type of energies or like our own neuroses, you know, like thinking in circles, and it gets rid of insomnia and it increases luck and opens new doors of opportunity and all this stuff. It helps you to be more empathetic and compassionate and increases your leadership abilities, all of these different things. Actually, my favorite thing about this is if you hide it in your kids' room, it helps them to keep their room cleaner. That's like the ultimate reason to have an aventurine stone. But anyway, you can get aventurine probably at your local rock store. It's a pretty common stone, but I also have them on my website if you're interested in that. And then if you get it from me, it also comes with like a video series on how to use your aventurine stone. So anyway, as well as like information on, hey, here's the angel that you call upon when you use the stone, and here's how you care for it. Okay, anyway, your power color of the month, lilac. Now, a good way to use this, you know, typically power colors, we can use them by wearing them. In the case of lilac, you could put some lilacs in your house or have like a lilac type of, you know, spray in your home, make things smell beautiful because our smeller, our sense of smell actually has the most to do with our emotional body and like feelings and memories and things like that. Actually, when you have deja vu, it's your brain trying to place a time that it has smelled a smell before, but it didn't bank into the long-term memory. So it just instantly creates a new memory. And so you're like, what the fuck? I've been here before. This is deja vu. But it isn't. that's our sense of smell playing with us in our brain. But anyway, it says strengthen your faith. Oh, isn't that interesting with our power color, the color of lilac? We started with strengthen your faith, connect to the spirit world, you know, whether that's through art or whatever it is that you do. This is beneficial to you for so many reasons. It's going to activate your intuition, which is going to help you to get the things that you want. It's going to increase your psychic abilities. This one kind of helps you to free yourself from old destructive patterns, kind of awakening your inner power. And so where is that? Okay, your affirmation. With every breath I take, my faith in myself and within the divine is renewed. I am ready to receive the highest love and abundance from the universe. Oh, really? You're ready to receive? Awesome! Because the universe is trying to give you some really great things here. But you have to open your heart up to receive it. So lilacs, aventurine, saying yes and thank you to people, allowing people to do things for you, to be there for you, is massive in the month of March. Okay. So getting back to your reading, what kind of energies do you need to bring into your life to help you find your happiness? And they're saying, you know, you kind of already know. Like, you'll just feel it when you listen to this reading. You're going to go, oh, actually, yeah, I've got some sort of an idea on this. And if you don't have the full idea, because with that card, it's kind of like you can kind of get part of the picture, but not all of it. Hey, guess what you do? You strengthen your faith. You say a prayer. You ask your spirit guides for help. Maybe you pull cards or you use a pendulum, something like that, okay? They're saying you're just not feeling confident enough is the problem. And this is where any sort of energy of confusion is coming through. But the more that you strengthen your faith and you increase your abilities to like really receive things, including intuitive guidance, the sooner you're on that path where boom, 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 things change overnight for you in a very positive way. So how are you going to sustain any happiness once you get some? And they say, paying attention to the details. What is it about this thing that I really love? Why am I happy this came into my life? You know, why do I feel good right now? And then just doing more of it. They're saying like some of you are just like deciding, I'm not going to be happy. I'm just going to like give up. Don't feel good. And they're like, this is so fucking stupid, because not only did you harm these two people, as you're walking away with these swords, look at the way he's carrying that. You know, he's like, oh, I'm smarter than you because like I'm realistic and like I'm a dream killer. Like, yeah, you know, this isn't going to work for you. Like, I'm a realist. I'm not like negative. I'm just saying, you know, stomping on other people's dreams and their faith and their hope and their optimism. And then he's like walking away with his swords of truth. Like, see, I told you so. I told you that was going to happen. You should have listened to me. I told you that was going to happen. But he's cutting his own hands. He's hurting himself. So don't be that person. You know, believe in yourself, in miracles. It's like have all this hope and this faith that good things are going to come to you, because they will. But if that's the action that you're taking, if you're telling other people that, you know, good things don't happen. Like, good things just don't happen to people like us, you know? The rich get richer, the poor get poorer. Like, well, if that's what you believe, okay, enjoy that life, because you're going to manifest it, and you're just hurting yourself. You're just slicing your own hands. So, anyway, it's kind of grim. March over, but I mean, point is, you get to make a choice. March overall, in a nutshell, first thing they say, indecision is a decision. Okay, not making a decision is a decision. So just make the fucking decision. Make the decision for yourself to like do things in the best way possible for yourself so you can enjoy this happiness. They're like, you get to manifest whatever it is you want into your life. The only things that we cannot manifest into our life are the things that we cannot imagine. Okay, so if you can imagine yourself like on a private jet, you know, like, people just throwing dollars at you, like, you know, like a stripper in Atlanta, then you can have that. You really can. You can have whatever you can imagine. I mean, how many people told Elon Musk he couldn't, you know, make a spaceship and fly it? And he just did that. He just did. I mean, I don't think he was on it yet, but he will be soon. And like when bro opened up, like, what was it, PayPal, like, you know, 20 years ago or whatever, he would have said, like, hey, someday I'm going to take an airplane. I'm going to make a spaceship, and I'm going to, like, launch it into space successfully. Everybody would be like, yeah, right, asshole. But he could do it because he could imagine it. And that's the thing, is the only things that are outside of the capacity of possibility are the things that we cannot imagine for ourselves. Okay? So they're saying, you know, honestly, a lot of you are not kind of taking the lessons that you've learned and deciding to move towards this piece. And you're saying, okay, well, I don't know. I don't know what I want to do here. But indecision is a decision. Okay. So make the action step decision, even if it's just a baby step of allowing other people to care for you. So I love you so much. And I hope you receive that with a big open heart. And I will talk to you in April. Video and getting all the way to the end of it. I really appreciate your support. If you are interested in other videos, click here. If you are interested in subscribing, go ahead and click here. Hit that notification bell so that you get alerted to when new videos come out and also when I do surprise live streams. And then if you're interested in winning a free 20-minute video
reading personally every month, go ahead and click right here. Mwah!